Alright guys, coming at you from another War Offense video, this time looking at Doc Ock. I'll show you him against Mercs and Human Coulson. Those are two matchups I prefer to use him on. But they're very good against large BKTs, take him out. Wave on Avengers, take him out. Emirators, I would suggest slight punch down. That can get a little hairy just with the health that Strife can get of Medallion. You may not be able to take him down quickly enough. But without further ado, let's get into it. Starting with the Inhuman Coulson matchup. So, 10k punch up, 137k black bolt. They don't have barracks or med bay. I don't have armory, but I do have hangar. This matchup is settled right here, right now. I didn't die, so we're good. You're going to see I'm actually going to do a couple misplays. I'm going to pause it for a second here. Just to elaborate, you don't really want to do this in security, and you definitely don't want to do this in reactor. Reactor is the biggest mistake you can make, because you're definitely going to get the... offense down. You're probably not going to get enough deflex to survive this. So, especially with these big black bolts. I mean, we saw 200k black bolt. That black bolt would have yeeted my Doc Ock off the field. So, I wouldn't recommend that. So right away, we get all our health back, right? We get the disrupt, no big deal. Peel off these buffs so he doesn't share them on his second turn. And this is where I make a mistake. I go for yo-yo. You don't need to go for yo-yo there. What you could do is you can go for crystals so that they're not going to get health rebalance when they are rather a heal when they drop by 50%. You can go for fury so he doesn't give them speed and defense up on his next turn. But most importantly, if you can't kill Yo-Yo by her second turn and she gives it energy, well then you wasted all your efforts killing her anyway, because she will have done the only thing that she's capable of doing in this matchup. Now my next misplay. I haven't made misplays like this before, or since I did this fight, is right here. So, Mysterio Special is a blind for one turn, won't affect Black Bolt, right? But also a two-turn ability block. So you get that on Black Bolt, you don't have to worry about Yo-Yo giving him energy, you don't have to worry about any of that. He'll have two turns of ability block, and then you can kill everybody before he's a problem. So, you'll see what happens when I don't do that mistake. Also, the ability block would have stopped him from using his special and Electro, which you'll see gets her killed. So, that's a wasted ability right there. Electro takes a big hit. She's okay for now. Rhino doesn't do much there. He did get a taunt out. Whatever, right? Electro's passive kicks in. Get rid of Coulson. That's great. Swarm, offense up. We almost got the yo-yo. Not down yet. So he got the energy, he gets his ult off, Electro dies, bad plays. Had I ability blocked, we would have been much, much better off. I blinded him and ability blocked him there now. What's the point at this point, right? We go ahead and we flip everything on Nick Fury, but he's dead anyway. And we just kind of clean up the rest, right? So even with those really two big misplays, it still worked out well enough. The trick to this fight is Doc Ock survives turn one. Mysterio special Black Bolt. Make sure Mysterio is big enough to land these abilities on Black Bolt, and you'll be fine. And of course, Black Bolt's biggest weakness is the slow. You put a slow on him after he takes his first turn, he's not going to take another move before you kill everyone else on the map. But this worked out well enough. This was a slight punch up. Since then, I've done like 30, 40k punch ups. Nothing crazy. You really have to judge how big your Doc Ock is, how big the Black Bolt is, and what rooms you're going into. So, alright, against Wakandia, this was a long time ago. Now we're going into what I think is the most unfavorable Mercs matchup into Doc Ock, and you'll see why here. It's got a Korath instead of the Killmonger. So, stop farting around, click that fight button past me. Any day now. There you go. I was doing this on stream, so I was talking while I was doing all that nonsense. So right away, ability block, horrible. We're gonna have to wait till turn two to do our thing, and then the blind goes on Electro and Swarm. Swarm will cleanse it, cool, but Electro's stuck, so we can't use her ult. So we're kind of stuck here on this opening turn. We gotta survive. Right? I'm sweating this already as is. Can't use any ability. We'll go for a slow. Doesn't land. Probably preferable. Can't use anything with her, she's blinded. He cleanses it. We'll try and get some debuffs on this guy, but he's gonna block the initial one, so nothing else is gonna land, right? The got to land the first one for Swarm to keep hitting. So block, nothing. We'll waste the heal block here for no apparent reason. So obviously I'm tilted. I'm in a bad spot, and here comes some bad news. Doc Ock stunned. Two turns, he's toast, right? Oh, dead in the water on this fight. There's no way I'm going to come back from this. You see, I still hold out hope. I still avoid using any abilities because I want to get that shocker offense up before I use these abilities. So, go ahead and try and peel the taunt off. We didn't. Doc Ock just cleared a stun. Cool. We're not going to use the ult. We really want that offense up. I need that for the Electro special and for the Swarm ult if I have any hope of winning this fight. Mysterio gets real low, but if he dies, he'll go clone, and then Electro is going to passive proc more or whatever, right? So, that's fine. He healed up anyway because Doc Ock's a beast. We're not going to hit that ability. Alright, Doc, it's your turn. So because Doc Ock's passive heals him every time he blocks, he's able to survive with this onslaught. He's a better tank than Rhino, so maybe you can use Green Goblin if your Green Goblin's bigger anyway. But anyway, we're not going to use that. We're going to wait for Shocker to get the offense up. It's going to devastate them, and then we're going to win this fight anyway. And this shows how Doc Ock really does dismantle Mercs. There you go. Offense is up. And you see there's a wide variety of buffs I could use here with the Shocker special. So I go ahead and I get that peeled off, the Merc, and then I look, I see this Lieutenant. See, he's got all these buffs, he's the healer, he gives some speed, he gives some offense up. Get him out of here. He's gone. Our Doc Ock gets in trouble, but he'll be okay. He is Doc Ock. He's gonna block so many hits here. Just waiting for our... There we go, Swarm with the offense up. Bam! That's going to be the end of Korath. Doc Ock finally gets his turn to flip with the offense up. That's huge damage. And now we're just playing, you know, finish the Taskmaster, which we'll do no problem. If you had a stronger Mysterio, he's going to peel off a lot more buffs. He's going to be way better. I think, obviously, Doc Ock, you want to be your strongest. Electro, Swarm, your second. Mysterio, you really want a big Mysterio too to peel off more buffs, to land those debuffs, especially on the Black Bolt, and to land it, say, on the Taskmaster. He's underrated. And the fifth member, Rhino, maybe I taunted too early here to make a difference. Taskmaster still would have done his thing. The fifth member, Vulture, I think that's a very flex pick there. Because Shocker's still going to come first, so... You don't have to go Rhino here. I just don't have the other Sinister Six members built up. So anyway, that's boring. You don't want to see that. I'll just show you it's a win. Obviously, he's not going to want to be five of us. And there you go. So, let me go and show you guys my Sinister Six. So you have an idea of like T4s and the power they need to be. I haven't put any more into this team in a while. Doc Ock's going to come with me up to Dark Dimension 4 at some point. So he is going to get bigger. He is obviously the biggest piece in this team. So that's going to help out. I have special, ultimate, passive done. All three of these, I'm going to say, are essential. This is just damage. However, it's going to be the part that gives the Shocker his third tap on his ult for that summon unit. Scream, I have the special and the ultimate done right here. Extra damage, bleed for two turns. That's nice. This is extra damage, all the bonus attacks. And then it applies some more debuffs, which is nice. The basic, it's not too important. You're mostly going to kill them with your abilities. And then I believe this is just drain. On turn, if charged, 10% healing, plus 2% dodge per charge. That could be great. You saw in that Inhuman Coulson fight, my Swarm almost died, but then he dodged Black Bolt's last attack and lived. I still would have won that fight regardless, but it was nice. And then for Electro, I have all of these done. For sure you want the passive. For sure you want the ultimate for the offense 2. Offense down for 2. And the special is really just like a huge kick in the nuts to whoever you're up against. Especially like you saw that Lieutenant. Got him right off the field. No problem. So I would suggest all three of those for her as well. And you'll see I have none for Mysterio. Although... This will call an extra random ally, which could be good. You get a Doc Ock slow on the Black Bolt, maybe. That'll be amazing, right? If I heal blocked all enemies, that one would be nice too. And this one just kind of summons a an extra mirror image, and you get a little bit extra focus, which is nice. This one, probably not necessarily you're going to have enough focus overall. But this one, because this is kind of like the focal ability that's going to help you with that Inhumane Coulson team, and you might get a slow from Doc Ock, that special is well worth the investment. And Rhino, you could do the passive if you really wanted to, just to have him live a little bit longer, to have the blind speed him up faster, put him beside Electro and Swarm. Maybe he's going to get it, he's going to save my butt on that Merc fight. It would have went faster, but it is what it is. It didn't work out. That's fine. As far as ISOs go, a healer on Doc Ock, of course, his health pool is huge. There's a bunch of healing. That's great. I have Raider on Swarm just because of the amount of times he hits. I also have Raider on Electro for the exact same reason. I have Skirmisher on Mysterio. You'll notice I don't have a Striker. Don't think a Striker is super necessary here. Their basic attacks don't do much besides Mysterio, and I think with Mysterio, especially if you can afford to take him to 5, which I would like to do eventually, he'll land those debuffs more often. And that's really going to be the focal point in winning these fights. Anyway, guys, hope you found that helpful. As always, let me know if there's any other fights you want to see me tackle and make a video on, and we'll go from there. See you later.